Become Project. Welcome to your tutorials for this week's routine. Today, I'm really going to focus on standing alternatives for series that we have on the floor. So I'm going to show you a lot of things that you can do with the chair to make this routine feel better for your body. And before we do all of that, I want to say thank you because I had a realization that I created this routine exactly 1 year ago. And 1 year ago, I wasn't offering chair alternatives. And the reason I started to add that in is because of you, because of your feedback, because of your ability to share what works for your body and what doesn't work for your body. And one of my favorite things about my job is that we learn together, right? In teaching you, you also teach me, and that is how we grow, expand, and we become more inclusive for a variety of body types. So thank you all so much. It was pretty cool today to see just how much we've grown and changed in routine style in only a year. So let's get started with the warm-up. Before I give you a standing alternative for the warm-up, I first want to talk about the downward dog form because a lot of questions came in about that today. And most of the questions were surrounding pain in the hands, the wrist, the arms, the shoulders, and the neck. And here's the thing about a downward dog. It's actually not supposed to give you any pressure in that area. And instead, it's supposed to be a nice stretch for the chest, that's primary, and then for the hamstrings, that's secondary. So let me show you what I'm talking about because I think you'll really be able to see it on the body. A lot of times when we do a downward dog, we're thinking so much about getting our legs to straight that it looks something like this. Now at this moment, my weight is really, really shifted forward into my hands. I'm putting pressure down onto the wrist. My arms are holding the bulk of the weight. My neck is already starting to tighten up. And yes, my legs are straight, but it almost feels like a weird plank with my butt up in the air. Okay, it doesn't feel great. So I want you to watch the change I'm going to make. From this position, I'm going to start by bending my knees a lot. I'm gonna get a nice bend, okay? Then I'm going to take my chest and I'm gonna push my chest backwards toward my thighs. Okay, now that shift that I just made took the weight out of my hands and it shifted it backwards, so I'm now getting that primary stretch that we talked about in the chest. Next step, okay, so look, wrong downward dog, bend my knees, push my chest backwards, let the head drop, shift the weight. Now I want to think about taking my tailbone and lifting my tailbone up to the ceiling while still keeping my chest down. So here I'm gonna try to start to tip my tailbone up while I drop my heels, and that gives me the secondary stretch, which is the hamstrings. So my arms push forward, my tailbone lifts up, my heels drop down, and that's where you're gonna get that really, really yummy downward dog. Okay, now maybe you are super tight in your chest or you're dealing with an injury and doing the down dog on the floor just doesn't feel right. Well, good news, you can get the same stretch, an awesome stretch, up here on a chair. So a standing downward dog would look a little something like this, right? I'm still getting that nice stretch. Notice how I am still bending my knees here. And then if I tip my tailbone up, right, that looks to you like I'm just straightening my legs, but I'm thinking about lifting my tailbone up while anchoring my heels. Now that gives me the secondary hamstring stretch. All right, so now I'm going to show you what this warm-up looks like done standing with a chair. So in the video this week, your warm-up starting position is a tabletop plank, hands and knees. Okay, so I want to show you what this position looks like up on the chair. If I bring my hands to the chair, I want to get my feet pretty much right underneath my hips with a nice little bend in my knees. And then with my upper body, the shoulders are stacked, but I don't want to say that they're stacked directly over the wrist because you're not up here, right? It's kind of a nice even weight balance between your hands and your feet. This would be our starting position. From here, you're going to follow the counts just like you see in the video. So on count one, swing to the right. Count two, swing to the left. Count three, take it to the right. Count four, move it to the left. Circle all the way around, arms down on five. Hands come out on six. This is the child's pose. And then on 7, 8, you're gonna step your feet backward to that chair dog that we talked about, your chair downward dog. Okay, so now we have that nice stretch in the chest, little bend in the knees. You start to bend one leg at a time. I bend right knee, left knee. Notice how every time I bend, I stretch my chest down to the floor. There we go. Count five, right leg is going to lift up. Count six, bend, turn open. And then on 7, 8, step yourself forward to that original starting position. Let's see what it looks like with some music, okay? Here we go. You move to the right, left, right, circle around, arms go down, hands go out, step backwards with your feet, bend right knee, now left knee, right knee, and left knee, leg goes up, bend, turn open, then step forward, repeat, hey. Options that you can do for your plank position. Okay, so after we do our little lateral extension and then we bring the hand down to the floor, when you step out to your plank, feel free to hit it and then you have a full 8 count to finish the plank where you want it. So you could very easily come to your knees and simply hold, or you could be on your knees and just kind of tap one leg out to the side, or you could just dip your hips down and up, okay? You could also do it on your forearms, which I cue often in the video. So there are lots of places that you can go in that plank, but today what I really want to focus on is showing you what it looks like standing up on the chair, because it's a pretty cool series. To perform this series standing, I'm going to have my feet just about hip width apart. They're parallel, really anchored underneath me. You're going to do the lateral extension standing. So pull the belly in, we tip one, halfway two, three, halfway four. We're opening up this side waist to get that nice stretch, yes. And then next 8 count, count one, right hand comes down, knees have a little bend. Now, I'm gonna take my right knee toward my left elbow, crunch and open. This would be 3, 4, open 5, go to a plank, 6, step back 7 and 8. Now you're free to take this plank how you want it. Again, you can hold, you can do hip dips, or what I primarily show in the video is tapping the leg out and in, out and in, out and in, then you step back forward to go back to the standing part. I want to show you what that looks like with music, just so you can see how smoothly it truly does flow. Ready? Tipping over, we go. 1, halfway 2, 3, halfway 4, 5, halfway 6, in 7, right hand down, 1, crunch in, open, crunch, open, hand, move to the plank, either hold, tap, or dip the hips. This is 5 and 6, back 7 and 8. You repeat 2, 3, and 4. Feel me? I'm gonna go ahead and do another round so you get the full visual. It's hand, crunch, open, crunch, open. Ooh, that's good. Yes, step it back, plank time. If you are experiencing lower back pain in the lunge series, I highly recommend that you scroll down and you look at Become Lunge Foundations, because I think that that's really going to help you get to that form that you need where you truly are hinging forward and pulling the low belly in and up. Let me just peek at that real quick, right? If I go here, I'm gonna feel back pain. Do you see how I'm swaying in my lower back? I'm letting my belly sink. Instead, I want to think about pulling the belly in and up and lifting the back hamstring to the ceiling. So now I'm anchored through my stomach. That should get rid of that back pain. So definitely review that foundation tutorial. However, what I want to say here really quick is about this leg moving out to the side or working this lateral lunge position. Oh my God, it's so tough, okay? So when you're bringing your leg around to the side, this is all about range of motion. If you feel low back pain when your leg goes all the way out here, maybe your range of motion looks a little bit more like this. Okay, so you can bend the knee so that it doesn't come in as far. And then when you stand up, cross and then like halfway out with this leg. Cross and then halfway out. And I think that that should get you to a good spot so that you can stabilize this leg without getting a lot of pressure in the side back. In your leg series this week, we are moving from a kneeling position to an upright lunge. So if some of the lunge form is confusing you, definitely check out our foundation tutorial called Upright Lunge, because I think that that'll fix up some of the knee issues. But, you know, this is not an easy series. I mean, you got to get from here, then you got to get that leg around, head up, and then move yourself into a standing position, right? So the chair is a really, really great option to help you through some of this. So let me just review the counts and then I'll show you once again with music. For the start, my right leg is underneath me. My left leg, working leg, is up. Here I'm doing some booty kicks, okay? So I'm taking little pulses up. And as I pulse up, I'm ensuring that I'm not doing one of these, right? I'm not swaying into my lower back and letting my shoulders sink. Instead, I've stabilized the torso, and now I'm pulsing that leg. So this is one, two, three, four. Count five, you're gonna bring your left foot forward, and then on count six, I need you to step your right foot about halfway back. So instead of doing the look up there, right, you're stepping back, and then you're lifting your hands. Okay, now, once we're in this position, we have to make sure that the majority of our weight is still over our front leg. This applies to everyone. We also have to make sure that our non-working leg, let me say that again, that the hip of the non-working leg is not sinking down. Because if we do this, we're gonna feel all kinds of pressure in this back leg. So I wanna lift this hip up in order to help me anchor my weight into my front leg and stay lighter on the back. So whether or not you're doing the chair version or the kneeling version, that applies to everyone. Okay, then from here, this is where we start to take our little twist side, and then we press ourselves straight up. Again, we twist side, knee ankle aligned. Now this leg pushes backwards to stand. One more time. Here's the bend, I'm aligned. This knee goes backwards. I press myself up. Great. And then for those of you on the chair, hands go back down, right foot comes forward, left leg is going to lift up. Music, here we go.
Try again, if I hesitate, to let you in.
Left leg, up one, up two, three, and four. Left foot, five, step back, six, little lift, seven, get aligned. It's a twist, and up, and twist. And up, one more, go twist, and lift, hands go down, right leg forward is one, two, belly in, three, and four, right foot five, step back six, lift it up seven, and eight, here we go, keep light on that back leg, twist, and up, one more, twist, and up, then hands go down, right foot forward, start it over,